I want to talk about steroid drugs. They're a double-edged sword. And I'm talking about the corticosteroids. I'm not talking about androgens or testosterone. Now, this drug is used mainly for anything connected with inflammation, like rheumatoid type conditions, rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, vasculitis, that's inflammation of your vascular system, asthma, hay fever, allergies, hives, psoriasis, COPD, that's a chronic lung problem, IBD, that's irritable bowel disease, MS, and all the other autoimmune conditions. Here's the problem. When I was in my 20s, I think it was like 25, I got poison ivy and it got really bad and I took steroids. Every year after that, probably for 15 years, I had to get a series of steroid injections to handle this darn poison ivy that I would keep getting every single year in the fall. But as the years progressed, it worked less and less to the point where it didn't work anymore. So if I get poison ivy, which I keep getting every year, I can't take another steroid injection. I just have to cope with it, live with it, and wait for this poison ivy to go away. And so my allergy to poison ivy has gotten pretty bad, where if I touch my eye, it just swells up. So if you do some searches on YouTube, you might find me doing a video with these dark glasses because I'm trying to cover up this severe poison ivy reaction that actually went into my eye. So it's pretty major allergy. But the steroids that I took really messed me up with my sleep cycles and my immune system. But the two big effects that this steroid cortisol has on our body are, number one, suppression of the entire immune system. Now, that's your army to fight all pathogens. So it's very, very dangerous to suppress your entire immune system. And the second effect is to suppress inflammation, another dangerous thing, especially in the healing process. So steroids suppress the T cells that help fight infection, especially viruses that invade your cells, that then the T cells are supposed to kill off, and now they can't kill them off. So we have this runaway viral infection. They suppress the macrophages that actually go around and eat viruses and yeast and parasites and bacteria like Pac-Man. Cortisol also suppresses the other white blood cells like the neutrophils, the basal cells, the eosinophils that have a lot to do with other functions of the immune system. When you've taken steroids for any period of time, it increases your risk for having a cold turn into a severe pneumonia infection. Also, steroids can greatly increase the risk of getting TB. Now, 25% of the population has a latent TB infection, which means it's in their body, it's in an inactive form. Well, going on steroids can bring that out into an active form of TB. And considering that 25% of the population has it, that's a lot of people. So steroids are a double-edged sword and should only be taken short-term, not long-term, and very infrequent. Because if you're taking them chronically, when you start to come off steroids, your adrenals basically have shut down, and now your body can't produce it, so you have all sorts of withdrawal symptoms, like osteoporosis, ulcers in the stomach and also in the small intestine, severe infection, diabetes, weight gain, like Jerry Lewis, who had a certain autoimmune condition in which he had to take steroids and he just kind of blew up. His whole face was like round. Cataracts, skin problems, and the list goes on and on. And so, if you want an alternative to steroids, there are a couple things that you can take. One, curcumin, which is a potent anti-inflammatory. If you're going to take curcumin, make sure you're taking at least 200 milligrams per day. Next one is boswellia, a very good anti-inflammatory. Next one is green tea, a very powerful anti-inflammatory. And then number four, vitamin D, which is my favorite, has powerful anti-inflammatory effects. You want to take at least 10,000 IUs, probably 20, sometimes 30,000 IUs or more. I have a bunch of videos on that. And then, of course, fasting, which creates some very powerful anti-inflammatory effects. All right, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.
Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.